to KidZone Online. My name is Miss Eleanor, and it's the perfect day for you to be here. You want to know why? Well, it's almost Easter. It's a new month, and that's a pretty big deal. You know, Jesus pretty much changed everything when he died on the cross, and then he came back to life. You know, it was kind of like he turned the whole world upside down. And you know, he was gave us the greatest example of humility. Humility is putting others first by giving up what you believe you deserve. Having humility is being humble. It's kind of an upside down way to live. You know, it's a lot more kind of natural to just put yourself first, right? To want what you want. But Jesus came and he flipped the whole thing upside down. He flipped it all around. He showed what it looks like to put others first. He came to serve and to be served. I know bottle flipping was a pretty big thing a couple of years ago, but I think it's pretty awesome still today. And so, you know what? Here at KidZone Online, we don't do anything halfway. In fact, we do things exponentially. So today, we're gonna do the exponential bottle flip. Contestants, this challenge will test your bottle flipping expertise, your plastic pitching perfection, your canteen cartwheels, and not just with this little gem I have in my hand. Oh no, I told you we don't play around here in KidZone. We don't do things halfway. This is exponential bottle flipping. All right, let's reveal the exponential bottle flip. In the exponential bottle flip challenge, the bottles you must flip successfully land increase in size exponentially. So if you don't know what that means, exponential means they gradually get bigger. So we start with this little small water bottle, and once you flip this one and land it, then we move on to this bottle. Once you successfully land this bottle, we move on to the liter size bottle. Once you successfully land this bottle, we move on to the gallon size jug. Once you successfully land this bottle, we move on to the big mama of bottles. And once you successfully flip that, all within 30 seconds, you win! You can do this! You can do this! Alright! So after one land, you move on to the next one. After one land, you move on to the next one. You got this. I know. Alright, we'll put 30 seconds on the clock. And then, you're off. Okay. With 30 seconds on the clock, go!
Flip it. Dip it, S-N double, O to the P. Baby, you too much for me. But I'ma show you, I know you, been waiting for this. So I'ma flip it, dip it, and ride with this. Ride with this, ride with this, ride with this. Ride, 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 ride. Flip it. Dip it and ride with this. Flip it. Dip it. Flip it. So one more flip it, flip it, dip it, and ride with this. Flip it. Flip it. dip it and ride with this. Flip it.
Congratulations, Miss Carrie. Now, let's dive straight in. It's time to lift our voices in praise to God. Don't hold anything back. Let me hear you. Give it everything you got.
This is Jacob, or, you know, just Jake. Is everyone okay? There was like an earthquake or something in my room. I didn't feel it when I was outside my room, but then when I came in the room, everything was turned upside down. My table, my bed, also known as my couch, my Ferrari, my sculpture. That's better. I don't know how this could have. Wait a second. Is there such a thing as Roomquake? Yeah, that must be it. Anyway, I'm supposed to talk to you today about something called humility. Humility is putting others first by giving up what you think you deserve. So that means like doing stuff for others, I guess? Like my friend Chris. He's really good at humility. I mean, he humiliates me like all the time. Am I saying that right? Humiliate. 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 He shows humility to me. He's super busy, but he always takes the time to put me first by playing his April Fool's surprises on me. Like the time he put my keys in Jell-O. Or the time he made me a tray of brownies. Brownies. And who can forget the old and screw the top off the salt surprise? Chris is a funny guy. Hey, you know what I think? And this is just between you and me. Chris is the one who turned all my stuff upside down. It wasn't a roomquake after all. This must have taken a really long time. I mean, he turned all my stuff upside down. I do need to call my mom. This must have taken a lot of work. I'm not sure that it's fair that Chris keeps playing all these April Fool's month surprises on me, and I haven't even got him once. I don't deserve this. What I deserve is to get him back. Was that my toaster? The story today is about Jesus when he prayed in the garden while his friends couldn't even stay awake to keep watch. Jesus didn't deserve that. I wonder what he did about it. Stay tuned. I'm gonna come up with a way to turn the tables on Chris. Chris is gonna notice when he goes in his room, the tables aren't the way he remembered them. I'm gonna get the revenge I deserve. I'm gonna get the revenge I deserve! Is what I'm trying to say. Yeah, okay.
Thank you.
Yep. Hello, so-and-so friends.
Hey to you and all of our viewers.
From near
and far.
Welcome to the so-and-so show.
I'm John.
And I'm Brandon.
And we have got a show for you today.
That we do. Why don't you tell them about it, John?
Oh, no, my friend, after you.
I insist.
No,
after you.
No, I insist after you. It's time to play a game we call After You!
And now for everyone's favorite game show, After You.
This is a game that requires humility, where you want to put the other person first. So, after you.
What am I supposed to do?
We're going to balance a cup of water on a book on our heads.
Okay.
Water balancing.
After you, yes.
Holding your breath in a bucket of water.
After you!
Standing on a box while being hit with a palm frond.
After you! After you! After you! After you!
Nope!
Whoa! Whoa!
Keeping a grape in your mouth.
What does it have to do with humility?
What?
I said, what does this have to
do? Oh! After you!
Thanks for playing After You.
What a great game.
Was it?
Yeah, I'm so much more humble than you. I put you first every time.
You did not put me first.
Sure I did.
No, you did not.
Sure I did. You were the first to drop the water, the first to choke on a grape. I put you first in the game, which makes me first in putting you first. Wait a minute. Maybe I should have put you first by telling you to put me first. But if you put me first, because I let you put me first, I'd still be first at putting you first, which means, oh! It was you who were putting me first all along. Well played, Brandon. Well played.
Uh-huh. It's Bible story time with Kellen.
What's up, guys?
Not too much, Kellen. Just being soups humble.
Oh, yeah? Well, then I've got a story for you.
After you, Kellen.
No. I'm humble.
Thank you. Our story picks up just after Jesus shared what he knew would be his last supper with his disciples. His heart was very heavy, so Jesus led his disciples outside to a place called Gethsemane, a kind of garden with olive trees. And Jesus asked Peter, John, and James to keep watch so he could pray. The disciples sat and waited, tired after a full meal, while Jesus went off by himself to pray to God. It was not a happy prayer. Something very bad was going to happen to Jesus that night, and he knew it. He was so sad, so anxious, and he prayed to his Father in heaven with all his might.
My Father, if it is possible, take this cup of suffering away from me. But let what you want be done, not what I want.
He prayed this way for what felt like an hour. But when he returned to his friends, he found them sound asleep.
Couldn't you keep watch with me for 1 hour? Watch and pray. Then you won't fall into sin when you are tempted. The spirit is willing, but the body is weak.
3 times, Jesus asked his disciples to stay awake while he prayed, and each time, his friends fell asleep. And then, it happened.
Are you still sleeping? Look, the hour has come. The Son of Man is about to be handed over to sinners. Get up. Let us go. Here comes the one who is handing me over to them.
The disciples watched, horrified, as Judas, one of their friends, came up to Jesus, followed by a large crowd armed with clubs and swords.
Greetings, Rabbi.
Friend, do what you came to do.
Judas went to Jesus at once and kissed him. This was Judas' signal to the armed men that Jesus was the one they should arrest. When they saw the signal, they grabbed Jesus. That's when Peter leapt into action. Peter took out a sword and lifted it. He swung the sword at the servant of the high priest and cut off his right ear.
Yeah! Go, Peter!
Woo! Yes! And then Jesus' disciples fought off the armed men and brought Jesus safely back home. Thanks for the story, Kellen.
Yeah.
Actually, that's not exactly what happened.
Oh, don't ruin this happy ending for me, Kellen.
So Peter cut off the servant's ear. But then, before things got completely out of hand, Jesus spoke out to the angry crowd.
Put your sword back in its place. All who use the sword will die by the sword. Do you think I can't ask my Father for help? He would send an army of angels right away. But then, how would the scriptures come true? They say it must happen in this way.
Then Jesus touched the man's ear and healed him. But Jesus' disciples, his friends, ran, leaving Jesus alone. He was arrested and taken away. To be continued.
That's not happy at all.
I know, but that's what happened. In fact, things got even worse after that.
Worse?
I don't get why Jesus was arrested in the first place. He didn't do anything wrong.
True,
And if he could have called an army of angels to save the day, why didn't he do that?
Well, it's like what Jesus said when he was praying. He told God, "Let what you want be done, not what I want." Sure, he didn't deserve to be arrested. And sure, he could have easily done something miraculous to save himself. But Jesus knew that God had a bigger plan, so he put God first. And really, by putting God first, he was putting us first, because we were the reason God sent Jesus in the first place.
Oh, so it is a happy ending?
You'll have to wait until next time to find out.
Ah, rats.
Or, you know, you could ask somebody how it ends or read it in the Bible. It's a very famous story.
Great idea, Kellen. Thank you for the story.
Yeah, thanks.
No problemo. I'll see you guys later.
Later. Okay, so now we know where to turn to find out how to put others first.
Yeah, the after you game.
No. Jesus.
Oh, right. Jesus!
Jesus put his friends first, mm-hmm. even though they fell asleep when they should have been keeping watch.
His enemies, too. He actually healed one of the guys who came to arrest him.
He put everyone first, which brings me to a question.
Oh, reveal the question!
How do you put others first?
By letting them order before me at a restaurant.
Oh, yeah, or by watching what someone else wants to watch on TV.
See, that's why... You sat through 14 hours of baking shows with me last week.
Yeah, and I still don't know what fondant is.
You know what? You win, friend. You win, my friend. You are definitely the most humble person
alive.
It's not
a competition.
Well, you're number one.
No.
You're number one. You're number one. No, no. You know, you're putting me first, so I'm number one. No, you're number two. You're number two.
Talk about it together.
You're number two.
How do you put others first? And we'll see you next time on the So-and-So Show. Can we go now?
Oh, after you.
Okay.
See? Now I'm number two. I'm number two. I'm number two. Wait. Ancient Romans used to use grapes as earplugs.
I can't hear you. I've got a grape in my ear.
I have a grape in my ear. I can't hear you. Do you know what they used to use grapes for as well? Like so. When they swim, oh, you knocked one of my, I can hear! I can hear!
Somebody's gonna get a mustard-filled donut later, and I'm finally gonna get what I deserve.
Hey, did you know that Jesus didn't deserve all that stuff that happened to him? Like when his friends ditched him when he needed them? And when those people arrested Jesus even though he never did anything he wasn't supposed to? And then, when he was put on that cross, I mean, what? Jesus could, like, calm a storm with his hand and bring dead people back to life. Why did he let all that bad stuff happen to him? Turns out, it was all a part of the plan. When God created the world a whole bunch of years ago, he knew people were gonna need help if they were gonna have a relationship with him. So, he told people he was sending someone who would have to pay for all the stuff they did wrong. And that someone was Jesus. But it's not like Jesus wanted to go through all that bad stuff. In the garden, he was like, God, any chance there's a different way to save the world and stuff? But then Jesus was like, it's not about what I want, God, because what you want is better. So, what did Jesus do to his friends in the garden who let him down? He put them first. And what did Jesus do to those people who arrested him for no reason? He put them first. And what did Jesus do for you, me, and the whole world? He put us first. It's kind of an upside down way of doing things. Putting somebody else first for no reason when they don't earn it or when they may not even deserve it. I bet we can put people first like Jesus did. You know, we could let someone else pick what restaurant to go to or what video game to play. We could give up our place in line sometimes. Or when someone surprises us by turning our room upside down, we could choose to not get even. So here's the one thing I learned today. Put others first. It's not about what we deserve. It's not about what we want. What God wants is better. So April Fool's month or not, I'm gonna put people first. And Chris, if you're watching, keep the surprises coming. But I won't be taking my revenge. I'll just be sitting here, getting what I truly deserve. A delicious, mustard-filled donut.
That's some good stuff right there. That's some good mustard. See you next time.
Jesus put God's plan first when he prayed in the Garden of Gethsemane. Even though it was super hard, Jesus faced it anyway. He put us first because he trusted God's plan. This was what God's big story was leading to all throughout history. This was why God had sent Jesus in the first place. Jesus had come to die on the cross to pay the price for our sins. It was all starting to happen just as the scripture foretold it. Jesus had been arrested. He was eventually on his way to the cross. But through it all, through everything, Jesus chose humility. He chose to put others first. I know I couldn't have done that. He chose to put us first. As we remember his example, we can choose to live the same way. We can choose to put others first. So what does that look like for you? What does that look like for me? Well, when's the last time you let someone else pick the game that you wanted to play? Or the restaurant that you wanted to order takeout from? Everything? Or at recess, when you guys were in school? You don't always want to be the one to pick the game. You can show humility. You can let somebody else pick the game first. Something that they want to play. Maybe they want to swing first. Maybe you could have them choose what they color first or use the markers first. Humility is like, it's like anti-selfishness. It's taking that me first attitude and turning it upside down. Instead of putting yourself first, it's putting others first and treating them the way that you want to be treated. Take a look at our memory verse for this month. Philippians 2:3. Don't do anything only to get ahead. Don't do it because you are proud. Instead, be humble. Value others more than yourselves. That's Philippians 2:3. All right, let's pray. God, thank you for Jesus. We can't begin to understand what he went through in the garden, but even through it all, he chose to follow your plan. He chose to put you first. Please help us to always follow you, no matter how difficult things might be. Help us to follow Jesus' perfect example of humility as we choose to put others first. We love you, Jesus, and we pray these things in your holy name. That's it, guys. We'll see you next week for Easter. Bye.